وذكر فإن الذكرى تنفع المؤمنين وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما يا أرحم الراحمين. We ask Allah عز وجل, teach us what benefit us from what you taught us and increase us in knowledge. آمين يا رب العالمين. My dear beloved respected brothers and sisters, I ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى to make me and you from the people who listen and apply. We spoke before about the importance of praying قيام الليل, تهجد. And we mentioned so many benefits and so many rewards for performing this ibadah. Tonight, inshallah ta'ala, our topic is what are some of the actions that we can perform and we will gain the same reward as Qiyam al-Layl. We will mention 9 actions that if we do, we will have a reward that is equivalent to Qiyam al-Layl. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us in the hadith, he said, hold fast to Qiyam al-Layl. Qiyam al-Layl is one of the greatest ibadat. Hold fast to Qiyam al-Layl because it is the practice of the righteous before you. And indeed, it is a mean. Qiyam al-Layl, it's a way to get closer to Allah Azza wa Jal. I'm still quoting the hadith. And it's a means of prevention from sin and expiation of bad deeds. Allahu Akbar. All these are some of the rewards of Qiyam al-Layl. So what are some of the actions that will make me gain the same reward as Qiyam al-Layl? Number one, performing Salat al-Isha and Salat al-Fajr in Jama'ah. The hadith is in Sahih Muslim. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, whomsoever perform Salat al-Fajr and whomsoever performs Salat al-Isha in Jama'ah as if he prayed half of the night, and whomsoever perform Fajr in Jama'ah as if he prayed the whole night. So when we pray Fajr and Isha in Jama'ah, it will be recorded for us the same reward as if I am up all night in Salat. Allahu Akbar. طيب, what about my sister who prays at home? If she could come to the masjid, alhamdulillah, welcome. But if she prays at home in jama'ah, inshallah, she will get the same exact reward. So that is the first one. Second, performing 4 rak'ahs of sunnah before salatul dhuhr. Not too many people know the importance of these 4 rak'ahs. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, praying 4 rak'ah before dhuhr is equivalent in reward to praying the salah during the time of sahar. Time of sahar, يعني time of suhoor, which is qiyam al-layl. Subhanallah. So it is equivalent to praying the salat of qiyam al-layl. 4 rak'ahs, I can pray them 2 and 2. Make 2, pray 2, make salam, and pray another 2, and that will give me the reward of Qiyam al-Layl. Third, in Ramadan, during the Taraweeh prayer, a man came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he said, I wish you have let us all night praying Qiyam Taraweeh. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, whomsoever pray with the Imam till the Imam goes, he will get the reward of Qiyam al-Layl, as if he spent the whole night in Salat. So praying with the Imam, Taraweeh with the Imam, till the Imam leaves the Salat, will get the reward of Qiyam al-Layl. Fourth, reciting 100 ayahs of Quran at night. Reciting 100 ayah from the Quran at night. What's the dalil? The dalil is in Musnad Ahmad. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, whomsoever recite 100 ayah of the Quran in a night, he will be rewarded as though he has worshipped all night long. My brothers and sisters, 100 ayahs recitation at night. Surah Al-Mulk. 30 آية. If I do that and I do maybe عبسة النازعات, that's 100 آية right there. And if I do سورة الملك also, so I will get an extra reward, which رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, whomsoever recites سورة الملك every night, he will the سورة itself will intercede for them until it save them from the punishment of يوم القيامة. He said there is a surah in the Quran which is 30 ayah will intercede for its companion, for the one who recites it, until he is forgiven. Subhanallah. So I'm getting few rewards. I'm getting the reward of every single letter 10 hasana. I'm getting the reward of qiyam all night, and I'm getting the reward of reciting Surah Al-Mulk, which is also a protection from the punishment of the grave. Allahu Akbar. How long does it take? 10 minutes maximum. 10 minutes to get all these rewards promised by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Number 5, reciting the last two ayahs of Surah Al-Baqarah. We gave a whole talk about that. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, whomsoever recite the last two ayah of Surah Al-Baqarah at night, kafatah, kafatah, is sufficient for him. Imam al-Nawawi rahimahullah, he said, sufficient for him means sufficient for performing qiyam all night. Sufficient for him for protection from the shaitan all night. Allahu Akbar. So, last two ayah of Surah Al-Baqarah, Aman al-Rasulu, all the way till the end. How long does that take? Maybe a minute, minute and a half maximum, subhanallah. So please make it a habit that you recite these two ayahs every single night. And that hadith is in Sahih al-Bukhari. Number 6, having good manners. Subhanallah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the hadith is in Abi Dawood, by someone's good character, a believer will attain the degree of a person who prays during the night and fasts during the day. Allahu Akbar. Someone has good manners, respectful, honest, truthful, generous, kind, forgiving, loving, courteous. All these are good characters, subhanallah. With these kind of manners, a person will attain the level as if he or she praying all night and fasting all day. Subhanallah. Plus the many, many other rewards that we attain when we have good manners. For example, Rasulullah said, he told us, the heaviest thing in the scale on the Day of Judgment is having good manners, plus any many many more that we mentioned in a separate episode of JAR. Number 7, taking care, helping a widow and the orphans will also make us attain that reward of Qiyam al-Layl. Rasulullah ﷺ said, the one who take care of a widow and the poor is like a mujahid in the cause of Allah, and he is like the one who constantly stands of prayer at night and observes fast without breaking it. Allahu Akbar. So checking up on a widow. You have a neighbor that is a widow and she's raising orphans, giving them a certain amount of finances, of help on a monthly basis. And especially if that widow is a relative, that is even more rewarding, subhanallah. So that is another thing that will make us gain the ajr of Qiyam al-Layl. Number 8, subhanallah, and that is specifically for Yawm al-Jum'ah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من غسل واغتسل وبكر وابتكر, whomsoever take a full ghusl on Jum'ah, and he comes very early to the masjid, walking, and he sits down and listen to the khutbah attentively, and he does not create any problem between any two people. Huh? If he fulfill all these conditions, what happens? Every step to the masjid is equal the reward of 1 year of fasting and 1 year of tahajjud, of qiyam. Yes, you heard right. 1 year. Every step. So the trip was 200 steps, 200 years of fasting and 200 years of qiyam. Allahu Akbar. My brothers, this coming Friday is a holiday, right? Everybody is off. Why don't you apply this? Walk to the masjid. Most of our brothers that are watching us from overseas, they can perform this ibadah on a weekly basis. But many of the people in the West, they cannot because they are working. So this Friday, and there are few Fridays of the year when we are off, make an intention that you want to practice this hadith. Wallahi, it's worth it. Every step, 1 year of reward. And the hadith is in Tirmidhi, and the hadith is authentic, 100%. Finally, the last one, subhanAllah. Look how kareem, how generous, how merciful is Allah Azza wa Jal. How many opportunities do we have? But we are the ones who are lazy. Listen to this hadith, and the hadith is in Nasa'i. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whomsoever go to bed with the intention to get up and pray qiyam, then he sleeps and he oversleeps until the morning, he will be or she will be given the reward of qiyam recorded for them because they made the intention before they sleep. And their sleep will become a charity given to him by Allah Azza wa Jal. Subhanallah. So my brother, my sister, before you sleep, you make an intention, I want to get up and perform qiyam. And we all know that qiyam starts from after Isha all the way till Fajr. And the best qiyam is the last third of the night. Make the intention, put the alarm, I want to get up at that time, tell someone to wake you up. If you did, Allahu Akbar. If you didn't and you made a sincere intention and you overslept, it will be recorded as if you are up. Allahu Akbar. So my brothers and sisters, these are 9 actions that if we perform them, they are equivalent to performing Qiyamul Layl, which is one of the greatest ibadat. Please do 1, 2, 3, as much as you can every day, so we can get that ajr. And also add to it performing qiyam. We don't want to do these things and stop performing qiyam. No, this is something bonus, inshaAllah ta'ala. Something bonus, inshaAllah. May Allah make us from the people who listen and apply. May Allah make our last deeds, our best deeds, and our last words, La ilaha illallah. I love you all for the sake of Allah. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.
كتاب أنزل إليك فلا يكن في صدرك حرج منه لتنذر به وذكرى للمؤمنين.